Designing a website can be a long process, but it doesn't have to be. I think it really comes down to what it is you want to achieve with the website. If it's just a brochure website where you're just kind of showcasing your product or your service, it doesn't necessarily need to be a really big, arduous process. Whereas if it's a key part of your service offering and it's a platform that you're building online, then it can be a very big project. So it does really depend on what it is that you're building. The biggest key to a successful web design is to ensure you have a detailed spec, a really good brief for any web agency to understand exactly what it is you want. And it's very important that for them to get it right as quickly as possible, that you communicate and you plan exactly what the performance indicators are. And then they can kind of direct their resources to where the most important parts of the web design will be. Wireframes help you to understand the content that's going to be on that page, the structure, the user flow, and how the site's going to work without any of the glossy finishes of a design. And I think it's really important to work that out before you get excited about how a website's going to look. It should be more about how it's going to function first for you to achieve whatever you've set in your goals in the specification. I think that's personal to a business and to a brand, and that's why it's so important to make sure that any web agency you work with really understand what your brand values are, because they could get a design completely wrong, or you could end up spending a lot of money on avenues that they explore that have nothing to do with what you want to achieve with how the website's going to look. So I don't think there's any strict rule of how it's going to look, but it needs to represent and follow your brand guidelines, I guess, if you already have those in place. So the development stage is basically when you take your design and you get it to work. So you have front-end developers and back-end developers. So front-end developers will deal with kind of what the user sees, and back-end developers will deal with all the effort that's done in the background by your servers or whatever service you're using, whatever platform you've decided to go with. I think it's important to have a kind of an understanding of the effort that goes into that, because that can be quite a long process. I think there's three types of testing. I think there's testing to see if a feature that's been spec'd actually works. And then there's kind of user acceptability testing. So can the user use it? And then the last stage of testing is kind of improving. So can we do this in a better way? Can we move something somewhere else and people will engage better or understand what they're doing? The first two are what you do before you launch. And then the third one is ongoing. You should always be testing your website. The last stage is launching the website. And I think it's really important to make sure that you achieve all the goals that you've set in your specification, but not to be over-precious about it being perfect. It's never going to be perfect. You're always going to be able to improve, and you shouldn't be delaying something that could potentially affect your business based on, you know, a colour not being quite right or something not being quite the right place. That's something that can always be done after launching. You should always be looking back and seeing how users are engaging with your site.